Educator, please come on the stage. Barrister Faisal Khan Toro and Chaudhary Munir Sadiq. I also request Mr. Mohammad Naeem Arshad, Seconds Judge. Please come on the stage. I also request Mr. Zafar Mahmood Mughal, President, High Court Bar Association, Rawalpindi, come on the stage. Mr. Zafar Mughal is the session chair for this session, and he has been kind enough to spare his time. Now, the speakers are here. We commence our program. We will begin with Mr. Mohammad Naeem Arshad. He is a serving sessions judge and presently posted as special judge central. So he has practical experience of all the issues relating to dispute resolution. So we will begin with him. Mr. Arshad, please.
In the name of Almighty Allah, who is most beneficent and merciful to us, first of all, I am very humbled, honored, and pleased to address not only strangers, but persons of intellect from legal fraternity. Particularly, I am looking at young upcoming lawyers who have to excel in the profession. And amongst them, there are future judges, senior lawyers, dealing with serious types of very genuine cases, inshallah. The distinguished guest of the honor on the stage and off the stage, although since last 13 years, I have been serving as a judge, starting my career as a district session judge. That in 2004, then promoted as district and session judge in 2014. And since then, I have been serving as special judge center, dealing with cases related to crimes, railway police, and mainly pertaining to anti-human trafficking, which is also one of the curse in our country. Almost all the developing countries, all the people endeavor to go abroad for earning livelihood, for their families, for their own selves, for bringing prosperity. But unfortunately, they have to face many difficulties, and in number of cases, they have to lose their lives due to unscrupulous elements and swindlers who induce them, get hefty amounts, and then leave them in the lurch. Sometimes on the borders of the seas, sometimes on the roads, sometimes in the jungle, and by dumping them in containers. And there are lot many more. But what is the effect? Which you will be astonished to come to know. A senior officer of FIO was telling me a few days back, and I said, how can we not control effectively and with an iron hand? What he said once, sir, we were present with, along with some other officers at the airport and receiving dead bodies of young people who died in some burden of African countries by trying to approach Western countries. And an old man of 90 years age was receiving dead body of his young son. But instead of screaming crying, expressing his sorrow, he took me beside him. He said, Sir, koi aisa tarika hai ki mera dooja talwar chala jaye. So this is the apathy. Why he said so? He was not having any affection and love for his own son at this ripened age. This is the situation which prevailed, unfortunately, in our country. People don't have equal opportunities of employment. Illiteracy is there. Lawlessness is becoming increasing day by day. Terrorism is a big curse in our society. So certainly, I was also perturbed. This is one of there are a lot many gory examples can be noticed. Newspapers are filled up such like horrible incidents. So now we come in a lighter way, which is also got related with the assignment which has been dealing that one by me. Alternate dispute resolution, as per notes from these three words, we can term it substituted methodology or mode of resolving the dispute, conflicts, controversies between parties. Especially in such like country where we live, 70% population still live in the villages, ignorance, illiteracy, egoistic society, cross discrimination, intervention of feudal lords, cats, robbers. So if unfortunately some dispute crop up between two individuals pertaining to some, we can say, ownership of lord, and that too was not fault of either of them. By some corrupt revenue official, he made some entry. The lawyer, senior lawyer sitting around here, hear me out. This happens in this society. So one has approached the court, having the success of a lawyer, and in this adversarial system and the code of civil procedure, there are many techniques which would give rise to that procrastinated litigation, which may last for years to years, even decades to decades. And even the grandfather was the original suitor. His grandson would be able to see the light and the dream would come true. And during the pendency of that matter, in the court of what? In the court of first instance, means the court of the civil judge, as per jurisdiction, territorial and the pecuniary. Then during that process for culminating that original suit, entire orders are passed by the courts, probably for appointment of local commission, objections are being received by the court, and those are being examined. Then the challenge is thrown by the other party. Even in a suit for partition, you just imagine, if a suit for partition means that the giant house of three or four brothers, and that is consisted of just five marlas, and one of them or two of them are having the possession of the same as well, whereas two others are living somewhere else, but they too are having meager sources with a paltry income. But the people, the brothers who are having the possession, they would try to linger it on. So they are enjoying the possession. And maybe one of them, who is otherwise shareholder and entitled for the share of that property, are in lieu thereof, if he says, okay, you just give me the money. If that is of worth of, say, 10 lakh rupees, whatever is my share, 2.5, Just give me, because I am living in a rented house, no doubt. But I have to put my daughter into marriage bond. But objection, plurality. So these sort of things are sometimes become very painful when we are here. But I believe, what I think very deeply and strongly, the reconciliation, mediation, negotiation, this alternate dispute resolution begins from the day when an intending litigant approaches the lawyer in the court. At least we should have the courage, we should have the compassion, empathy, by going through just fire. If you do not find any force, any substance, factually and legally, and you understand after counseling and with some sort of conversation with that intending litigant, and if you are convinced, don't think of this, if I will not accept this plea, you will go to another lawyer, you will definitely pay the fee. But what is our intention? We should, I strongly believe, and I think everybody should focus on this. Ultimately, we all are answerable to Almighty Allah. And this, we all hold the teachings of Quran, the Sunnah, and the, you know, everything revolving around the intention, niyat. And it's just for the sake of this cookie is going to pay me the fee, and I'm accepting the brief, and then lingering it on for years. If some lady comes, and here, having two kids, the age of just 35 years old, small kids of 1 year and 2 years, and maybe she has been brought by some unscrupulous element, she may be brought by some lady of bad character, and if even she says, okay, I want to get dissolved my marriage, but he is some dear, he is a thief and he is against it. And normally, who was a lawyer, you will see that there are stereotypes of pleadings. For example, her husband is divorced, keep lies on with woman of easy virtue, who is drinker, he is daughters, he is, doesn't like to pay with the maintenance. Maybe if you see that gentleman, you could have been able to discover the whole truth. So there are not many, in every sphere of litigation, there are some persons sitting behind. Very normally, diligence, it is a common practice. The person, the big landlord, for some other ulterior motives and for other hostility with that innocent person who has been dragged into litigation through his own relative, who was playing in the hands of that feudal lord. So, what is required to be seen at the first juncture of your professional assignment? Whenever you see and you come across that litigant, if he has the case that is falling within the parameters of law, there is an actionable remedy can be made. He is having strong evidence, documentary, or okay, it's all right. So, this sort of scenario, we are so similarly wasted of time. This is if we resort to words, and no, you would be pleased to know the Sayyid Nuzhur Ali Shah, the most vibrant, energetic, and straightforward Honorable Chief Justice of Lahore High Court, has been striving hard to promote this culture of ADR. And this is not a new thing in this country. In the Punjab, you just visit YouTube, you just visit any website, make search on Google, even United States of America, in UK, in India, where millions of cases have been pending, those have been lingering on for decades, people have been suffering. And almost wherever the adversarial system is prevalent, either in a developed country or developing country, it's a common feature. It's not a new thing for Pakistan. So then they thought, because in the procedural laws, there are not many hiccups, not many hiccups. We can't blame that CPC or CRPC. In fact, when it was, drafted, it was compiled, TPC's president, and otherwise CPC whoever was the compiler. At that time, in fact, this was the colony that was being ruled by the UK. They were having a different jury system and blend of inquisitorial and adversarial. But unfortunately, they have given us that very comprehensive, no doubt, exhaustive CPC, which covers all aspects. There should not be even the slightest possibility that one should escape from going through that process of law. But unfortunately, that is since rampantly and abundantly being misused. And due to that misuse, the general cases are lying in the shelves of the record room. So if we concentrate towards ADR, because there's no particular stage is mandatory for entering into ADR or going towards alternative dispute resolution. At any stage, first step, which I have described before you and discussed with you, and I am also mindful of the fact, because I have switched over from advocacy, and I am also conscious of my inability. Because when you are a lawyer, you have to speak and judge has to listen. Judge has to listen, he has to be a good listener, and he should give patient hearing to lawyer. My friend would follow me, speakers, they have been specifically assigned about the nitty gritty of this area laws, but mainly, even before the existence of Pakistan in 1940, that too in the British Raj and in the British regime, there was an Arbitration Act, and those provisions were certainly inserted, appointment of arbitrator, referee, then award is called decisions, and some amendments were also made, but that too could not fulfill the actual objective for which it was promulgated not many years back. But no, the professor would speak on that. The latest ADR Act of 2017, that too is a flat factor statute that has been passed, in which the role of lawyers has been significantly postulated, and because of that insertion of their roles, so I would also I'm optimistic of the fact, I'm sanguine of the fact that lawyers should not think of it, they should not create any resistance, either soft or stiff, because they mean opportunity of earning. So, like speedy justice, if ADR, expeditiously decision can be made, because the rules of evidence are not applicable. But just because of the paucity of time, probably, I have a good news. On the one hand, it is a matter of dismay and concern as a nation. But for the lawyers community, a few days back, I was going through the pages of some journal and newspaper. Shockingly, in the mediation process, when the contracts between two governments are setting up any mega project between the government and some private company, independent power projects, like construction of big dams, like motorways, so forth and so on. A few years back, there was a cascade Turkish company, cake and days, but I can't pronounce properly. It was giving in setting up independent power project. They signed an agreement with the government of Pakistan. But due to non-transparency, foreplay, involvement of kickbacks, ultimately, then Honorable Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of Pakistan, who was known in taking such like action, went through that, yes. And ultimately that government was forced to non-completion of that. You will be stunning to notice, so when they approached, that company approached the agreed forum of international arbitration of London. Therefore, the clause is inserted, okay. In case of discrepancy or default on the part of any of the parties, so that forum would be approached. And Pakistan had to hire the services of international law firms, which is shocking for me, because we don't have the lawyers. So they can excel in the same. And even if sometimes the people are sent, they are sent on the basis of some other consideration, because of some relationship. So if you people excel in this, so you can learn more, then you can get expertise in drafting of contracts, and then you can be made mediator, then you can plead the case before the international forum. For learning, there are a lot many opportunities. IPP and like recorded, there are many such like international disputes, those are still pending, and Pakistan is bound to pay $800 million, and even they paid 1,034 crore rupees to that international firm for contesting that case which has been lost. So there are much can be said about that and on some other. Again, I would be highly thankful to the auspices of Lord Adenauer Stiftung, a German organization, who very kindly arranged this seminar symposium with the coordination and collaboration of Society for Enforcement of Rule of Law. Since it is my first interaction with the captains of this organization, and rather met with the Tarbil also, and very good friends. So I am again highly thankful and indebted to their kindness and grace which provided me an opportunity to speak. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Neymar Shishab, for giving an introduction of the topic. Now I request Chaudhry Shiraz Sohail.
The question is, how government will notify them? There are so many liars. How they will be placed on the panel? I think rules will cover this aspect, because in the Act we have no such thing from which I may answer how the name shall be placed. However, the effect on the IR will be positive, because it has no negative. Third question is, for our advocate High Court, question is, shall the proceedings of ADR be reduced in writing or not? What is the period to announce judgment, arbitral award? These questions, I think, have already been answered. However, once again, we submit that Section 10 deals with it. And when neutral person is acting as mediator or conciliator, he is supposed only to record a settlement. He records a settlement that the parties have reached to such and such settlement, and the parties sign to that settlement, and he submits this settlement paper before the court. If he is acting as arbitrator, then he announces we have the same powers as the powers of our courts, because they were the ultimate arbiters, and they had more powers than our courts. They can enforce their decisions. They were head of even the executive, as we got that right. However, the panchayat system or failure of panchayat system, as we have had in subcontinent, it was because the legislature did not support them properly, and introduction of police system even deteriorated their and undermined their authority, whereby an easy and inexpensive way of adjudication was lost. And furthermore, it was deteriorated due to our socio-economic conditions. Because morally we are going towards deterioration and we are morally corrupt. Even if we do claim that we are honest, in fact we have some elements of bias in ourselves which are to be addressed. And last question is, Tuba Azim, could you please share your thoughts on alternate dispute resolution bill? I think this question already stood answered and need no more answer. Another question is from Samar Tare. In monetary terms, to what extent can an arbitrator decide a dispute? Is there any provision related to this act? In this act, there is no such provision and there is no monetary jurisdiction. But when court refers the matter, it is evident when court has jurisdiction, and if the civil judge third class is referring the matter, it will certainly matter relating to jurisdiction of that court, and the civil judge first class refers the matter, it shall relate to the jurisdiction of that court. And even during the PTE part, the court may refer the matter to the neutrals for alternate dispute resolution.
Thank you, for answering his question. Now I request Mr. Zafar Mahmood Mughal, President of the Lahore High Court Bar Association, Rawalpindi Bench, Rawalpindi, who is our session chair for this session, to share his views with the participants.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
About the basics of alternate dispute resolution. Chaudhary Shiraz Sohail for giving an overview of the prevalent laws in the country during the last 100 years.
Shukriya.